Who is Chris Date? And why should we care what he says? Stay tuned.
God is at peace with the world. He is at peace with you. How can this be? Jesus died for your sins. Jesus was entombed. Jesus was roused the third day.
At the end of this video will be links to related videos. Check them out. Annihilationism is also known as conditional immortality. I will let Mr. Date explain what that is to you.
We annihilationists believe in what's called conditional immortality. Immortality is a gift, and it will only be given by God to those who meet the condition of being saved. Everyone else, when they rise to face judgment, will remain mortal and will in fact die.
And according to annihilationism, those resurrected mortal at the Great White Throne will be cast into the lake of fire and killed and be dead forever. Annihilationists do not believe that Jesus saved everyone through his death and resurrection, even though that is why he was sent by his Father. John 3:17 tells us, "For God does not dispatch his Son into the world that he should be judging the world, but that the world may be saved through him." You've probably heard the phrase eternal life and possibly the phrase eternal death, but rarely, if ever, do we hear what the definition of eternity is. The definition of eternity determines our proper understanding of things that are said to be eternal. Let's take a quick look at the meaning of eternity. Eternity has no beginning and no end. Therefore, anything that is truly eternal has no beginning and no end. Therefore, only God has eternal life, life with no beginning and no end. An aeon, on the other hand, has a beginning and an end. The Greek adjective aeonian is a common form of the Greek base adjective aeonios. Things that are said to be aeonian are described as they relate to the aeons. In comparison to eternity, which the scriptures say little to nothing about, is the Greek noun aion, which is a time period with a beginning and an end. Eternity and aion do not mean the same thing. Aion is used in the scriptures about 120 times, and over half of those are in the plural form. Are there a plurality of eternities? No. And in comparison to things eternal, which the scriptures say little to nothing about, is the Greek adjective aionios, which describes things in relation to the aeons, which have beginnings and endings. Aionios is used in the scriptures about 70 times. Annihilationist Pied Piper Chris Date sends confusing and contradictory messages to his hearers in regards to eternity, eternal, aeon, and aionios. His inconsistencies become apparent if we pay close attention to his words. Chris participates in a lot of formal debates on various topics. I was very surprised to hear his following revealing statement in an episode of Rethinking Hell.
When I debate universalists, I typically steer clear of the eternal texts because I don't want to get into this whole debate over whether the adjective aionios means eternal or just age enduring or whatever. It's a strategic move I make.
So why would Chris, who is a very smart guy, avoid the eternal texts and the texts that have to do with aionios? Well, only he can answer that question fully, but I have two ideas as to why he avoids these texts. Number one, they're detrimental to his argument. Because he believes in everlasting or eternal death and destruction for those who are not saved by Christ. And number two, he has many contradictions in the things he said concerning these words, eternal and aionios and aeon and eternity. And when you do a lot of debates, you don't want to have contradictions in what you've said. Now, none of us are perfect. We all have some contradictions here and there in the things that we've said. But if you're going into a debate, you definitely don't want to debate those areas where you have contradictions, where your thoughts and ideas you've presented are muddy on this issue, because that can be very detrimental to your argument. And a good debate opponent will see that, and that's the first thing that they will go for. Let's take a look at some of Chris's inconsistencies concerning these words.
Now, I'm glad that Dr. White quoted the Greek here from John 28 because he proves my point. The Greek is oume apollontai eston iona. That means shall surely not die into forever or into eternity, or for some who question the meaning of iona, into the ages.
Here we can see John 10:28 that was just referenced in the previous clip. It says, never not shall they perish to the age. And this is the part that they were quoting. And I want us to focus on the word here, iona, which is a noun in the accusative masculine singular. So we have a singular form of ion, and this is talking about an individual age. And I just want us to focus on what Chris referred to iona as. He said forever, eternity, or ages. Now, I think it's important to understand when somebody does reference ages, oftentimes those that believe in eternal torment or eternal death will say that there is an unending string of ages, which actually means forever, but that is not true. And I reveal that in other videos where we talk about the consummation of the ages, which is in the scriptures. So I would encourage you to take a look at those. I will have links at the end of this video to some related videos that go a little deeper into ion and ionios and eternity and eternal. In the next clip, we will see more contradictions from Chris as he discusses these words with Warren McGrew on Warren's channel, YouTube channel, Idol Killer. I've edited out parts of this clip because there's a lot of things that don't really pertain to what we're discussing here. I feel I've done justice to this and not picking and choosing parts. If Chris sees this and he thinks that I have, I guess that's up to him. But I'm just trying to condense this down so that this video doesn't last for 30 minutes.
Based on my research, the Greek word ionios, which does derive from the noun ion, meaning an age or an epoch, an era. The word ionios, nevertheless, does seem to mean everlasting, ongoing, never-ending. We would say that everlasting punishment, ionios, Colossus ionios, the Greek there, everlasting punishment, once the wicked are killed on the day of judgment, their life will be deprived from them forever. So their punishment is, by definition, eternal.
Help me, Jesus. Jesus.
Chris just drove the car into the ditch. I'm going to try to get it out. Hopefully this won't take too long. Chris is correct in this video clip in that he says, ionios does derive from the noun ion and means an age, epoch, or era. I would have some problem with two of those words, an epoch or an era, where he says it's an age. I can live with that. An age and an eon are pretty much interchangeable. Epoch and era, not so much. The good thing about all three of those words is that they are time periods with beginnings and ends, and we see that an ion has a beginning and an end. So at least Chris is understanding that an ion has a beginning and an end based on the words he used, where previously he had said a singular iona, he gave the impression it could mean forever, eternity, or ages. So at least here he's kind of narrowed it down, but you can see where he has contradicted what he has said previously concerning ion. So at least he understands that ionios derives from ion. But then he drives the car perpendicular, square on, into the ditch when he says that the adjective ionios, which is often used in the form ionion in the scriptures, he says that, nevertheless, seems to mean everlasting. He doesn't seem sold on the idea, but this is what he uses when he goes ahead and speaks to Warren McGrew on this YouTube channel. And Chris goes on to talk in this about the punishment being everlasting and forever and eternal. So again, everlasting and forever, I would say those are pretty much synonyms because they're talking about unending into the future, whereas eternal has no beginning and no end, which we saw eternal Anything that is truly eternal has no beginning and no end. So it's impossible for the punishment of a created being to be eternal, because the created being had a beginning. Any type of punishment it undergoes would have a beginning. So you can see how he's continuing to muddy the waters, using forever, everlasting, eternal. He's taking the adjective eternal and using that with the noun ion. And that is totally unacceptable and inexcusable. You can't swap those around. Things that are Ionian are described as they relate to the ions. And an ion has a beginning and an end, and all of the ions have a beginning and an end. But Chris is making a huge muddy mess out of this when he's throwing these terms around, mixing them up. I understand these terms, but somebody saying, hey, I wonder what this Chris Date guy has to say, and then they swallow this line of BS, hook, line, and sinker, when it's just a muddy mess in actuality. The words we use are important. The words we use have to have meaning. You cannot apply an adjective that's based on one noun to another noun. That's just completely inexcusable, especially when those two nouns are as far apart as eternity and ion. I hope this makes sense. I understand this stuff, so it makes sense in my brain, but I hope I've communicated this to you. Chris is speaking of things that are just not scriptural. He's abusing language, stretching adjectives to mean things that they do not mean. Thus, you have eternal, forever, and everlasting punishment, which the scriptures speak nothing about, even though Chris will tell you that's what the scriptures teach. Don't believe it. Chris has muddied ideas with his careless handling of words, and I would just encourage him and anybody watching this that words matter, man. Psalm 12:6, the words of Yahweh are clean words, silver refined in a kiln, fine gold purified seven times. And Paul to Timothy in 1 Timothy 1:13, have a pattern of sound words, which you hear from me, in faith and love which are in Christ Jesus. All of annihilationism's proof verses can fit easily inside the truth of the salvation of all through Jesus. There is not one bit of death, destruction, and judgment within the scriptures that contradicts what Jesus accomplished for all of mankind and all of creation through his death and resurrection. Annihilationism is a doctrine with a tiny Jesus. It is too small of a man-made doctrine to handle the true Jesus, the Savior of all mankind. Following is some of the fallout from the false teaching of annihilationism by Chris Date, those at Rethinking Hell, and annihilationists throughout the centuries. Annihilationism turns the truth of God being all in all in 1 Corinthians 15:28 into the lie of God being all in some. Annihilationism says all who are dying in Adam are not vivified, made immortal, contradicting 1 Corinthians 15:22. Annihilationism says Christ does not undo the acts of the adversary, even though 1 John 3:8 clearly says that is one aspect of Jesus' mission from his Father. Annihilationism says Christ does not accomplish God's will to save all, even though that is another aspect of his mission from his Father. 1 Timothy 2:4 and 4:10. So here's my tiny bit of advice to Chris Date, annihilationists, and those at Rethinking Hell.
Help me, Jesus! Help me, Jesus! Help me, Jesus! Help me, Jesus!